There is a quote by Carl Sagan that goes like this. The nuclear age will end when we have learned to appreciate 100 years from now what a miracle it was that we survived. I want to talk to you about this quote today because I think there are two parts to it. One is optimistic and one is pessimistic, and both of them need to be talked about. First, let's look at the pessimistic part. The fact that we survived for so long with such destructive technology, it's a miracle. In other words, we were very lucky. We humans have been developing nuclear weapons for almost a century now, ever since we split the atom. And in that time, many near accidents could have led to the destruction of all life on Earth. And yes, I know that we have had two world wars and a cold war in that period, but things could have gone much worse. If just one more switch had been flipped or one more button pressed, we could have seen an exchange of nuclear weapons. And if that had happened, we wouldn't be here right now. So yes, we were lucky. But Carl Sagan wasn't done. He continued and said that we will only realize what a miracle it was that we survived 100 years from now. And I believe he meant that most people do and understand how close we actually were to mutually assured destruction. Most people don't understand the insane odds that we beat. Just think about this for a second. When you walk outside, when you take a step, you literally put your life in the hands of thousands of other people. You trust that the pilot flying the plane above you made it through flight school and hasn't drunk too much coffee today. You trust that the bridge you're redriving on was built correctly and the materials used haven't degraded over the years. You trust that the people around you feel the same way about you as you do about them, that they won't snap and attack you for no reason. In other words, you live every day under the assumption that everything is working normally. And I say this with respect, but sometimes we are too dumb to realize what's possible, what could go wrong. We can't comprehend something called chaos theory, which says that small differences in starting conditions can lead to wildly different outcomes. In other words, I could have sneezed instead of stepped on that particular step and thus saved myself and a million other lives, but nobody thinks about that. And this is why Carl Sagan said that 100 years from now we will realize what a miracle it was that we survived. Because it wasn't our intelligence or power or ability that kept us safe, it was luck. And even though luck is a great thing to have, you shouldn't rely on it. And this brings me to the optimistic part of his quote, the fact that we will survive for the next 100 years. This, too, is a miracle. The difference between then and now is that now we know what we don't want. We don't want to blow up the planet. We have experienced the horrors of war. We have learned the hard way what happens when we aren't careful. And we have developed systems and processes to prevent another global catastrophe. Now, this doesn't mean that we won't have any problems in the future. Of course not. Climate change, resource depletion, pandemics, these are all serious issues that could doom our civilization. But none of these issues are nearly as dangerous as nuclear war. And this is why I think we will get through the next 100 years. We will get through it because we know better. We will get through it because we have learned from our mistakes. We will get through it because we have systems and processes in place that didn't exist before. Things like safety mechanisms, double, triple redundancy, checks and balances, separation of power. These are all things that we have developed since the end of World War II, so yes, Carl, 100 years from now, we will look back at this period in history and call it a miracle that we survived. But maybe it's not the time we thought it would be. Maybe the miracle isn't that we survived World War III. Maybe the miracle is that we survived World War II. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next time.